everyone.
Morning.
Today we find ourselves 40 days after Christmas. It is on this day, 40 days after Christmas, when we celebrate the presentation of the Christ child into the Holy Temple. All of you who are parents should feel a special connection to this feast today, because this is the event we are replicating when we bring our newborn 40-day-old baby to church for the 40-day blessing, where the priest carries the baby from the back of the church all the way up to the holy altar. But today we are going to focus on one aspect of the gospel, on one character in today's story. We're going to focus on the old man, Simeon, who received and carried the Christ child into the temple. It is the role of Simeon that the priest replicates during the 40-day baby blessings when he carries the baby up the center aisle and to the altar. Now, let's look at who Simeon was, or as he is called, the Holy Righteous Simeon, the God Receiver. According to church tradition, Simeon was one of the scribes called upon to assist in the translation of the Holy Scriptures into Greek. More specifically, he was one of the scribes that helped translate the prophecy of Isaiah. When translating his scroll, Simeon came across the text, "Behold, a young woman shall conceive in the womb and bring forth a son." As Simeon was supposed to translate young woman as virgin when referring to the mother of God, the Theotokos, the Virgin Mary. But Simeon had a difficult time comprehending that a virgin would bring forth a son, so he kept his translation using young woman instead of virgin. When he determined to translate young woman, the archangel Gabriel appeared to him. The angel told Simeon that virgin was, in fact, the correct word to use. And the angel also told Simeon that he would live to see the day when this prophecy would be fulfilled, the birth of the Son of the birth of the Jesus Christ, the Messiah, by appearance of his virgin. And so Simeon obeyed the angel, using the word virgin in his translation. Now let's fast forward many, many years to the event we celebrate today, the occasion of Christ being brought into the temple as an infant. The now very, very old Simeon is there, after all this time, waiting to see the prophecy fulfilled as the angel foretold. He soon recognizes that Jesus was in fact the Messiah of Israel, born of a virgin. And when Simeon sees the Christ child, he calls out to God, "Lord, now let your servant depart in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all people, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel." Simeon knew that he could now finally, after all these years, depart in peace, or pass away, as all had taken place according to the word given to him by the archangel Gabriel. There was nothing greater Simeon would accomplish in life. He was indeed a holy man who fulfilled his great role of receiving the Christ child into the temple. And according to Orthodox tradition, he indeed died the very next day. Now that we've covered Simeon, let's talk about another man. Let's talk about Kobe Bryant. Now, Kobe needs no real explanation as far as who he was. He was the Michael Jordan of my generation. He accomplished more in the world of basketball than almost any other person to live. He had gone on after basketball to win Emmys and Grammys and be recognized for philanthropic work. But Kobe's fame and success and fortunes are not why we are talking about Kobe today. We are talking about Kobe Bryant because he had something much more valuable than fame and success. Kobe Bryant had a very real and a very devout faith in Jesus Christ. His faith was a quiet faith. They say Kobe used to sneak in and out of the back door of his church so as not to distract anyone else in the church. In other words, it was important to Kobe for everyone to stay focused on Jesus Christ and worshiping him, and he didn't want to take people's attention off of what is really important in church, Jesus Christ. Now, as we all know, tragically, Kobe Bryant died suddenly and unexpectedly in a helicopter crash 1 week ago while we were all here in church. What is amazing, though, is that the very same day of his death, Kobe Bryant was in church himself at 7 a.m. He quietly had snuck in and out, just like he always does, and even briefly stopped to chat with his priest before leaving. As tragic as Kobe Bryant's death was, I can't help but realize the similarity here between his death and the death of the righteous Simeon. When Simeon died, it was not a sad occasion. He was very old, and receiving the cross crown was the only thing left for him to do in his life. Now, Kobe Bryant's death was tragic because of how young he was. But when we see that Kobe Bryant also received Christ in the form of Holy Communion on his last day on earth, we find that same calming element we see in Simeon's death. Kobe was a man who was always ready in his life. Though he was very talented, he worked and practiced his skills as thoroughly as a person with no talent. It is clear that he approached his faith in God in the same way. He was active in his faith, regularly making it a point to attend church with his family and receive Holy Communion despite how busy he was. In other words, although he died early, spiritually, he was ready to meet God, just as Simeon was finally ready. When we look at his death this way, we find the same calming aspect we see in Simeon's life. Fittingly then, the famous words of Simeon that we hear in today's Gospel of all days act as an appropriate prayer on the occasion of the passing of Kobe Bryant, a man who was focused in his faith and had just received Jesus Christ the morning of his passing. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel. Amen.